Whoa. Looks like I just found Derek's retirement funds.
Hey, Vito. We can take things from here.
What about the cops?
Yeah.
Like I just found Derek's retirement funds.
Hey, Vito, we can take things from here.
What about the cops?
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build.
Thank you.
Looks like I just found Derek's retirement funds.
Hey, Vito, we can take things from here.
What about the cops?
Shake the cops.
Thank you.
We got a homicide here. Suspect is armed. Copy that.
Gotta shake the cops.
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, average size. Roger that.
Empire Bay Police Department, Sergeant D'Amato speaking.
I need to calm down the situation.
All right, you got it. Have somebody drop the cash off later.
Joe wasn't home. At first, I thought he was just running a little late, so I went to grab something to eat. Two hours later, Joe still wasn't home. It was getting dark, and I was getting worried. I had to go look for him. Maybe Joe checked in with Eddie at the Falcon.
Vito, good, you're here. You hear what happened?
Wow, what's going on?
Henry's dead.
What?
The fucking chinks hacked him to death in broad daylight.
Why?
So you don't know anything about it?
Well, Henry wanted to bring me in on some deal, but I passed. What happened?
Yeah, well, Henry is, well, was stupid. He was dealing dope with the Tongs. He knew this was off limits and he got caught. Carlo let him off with a small fine and told him he'd forget about it. But the chinks double-crossed Henry and hacked him to pieces in the middle of the park.
Shit.
Ain't no doing business with the yellow man. But there's worse. Henry wasn't working alone. Yesterday, some guys massacred a shitload of the chinks over in Chinatown. Now they figure it must have either been us or Vinci. They already started threatening Vinci. If this don't get settled fast, we're all in deep shit. You sure you don't know nothing about it?
Not a thing, Eddie, I swear.
Yeah? How about Joe?
Joe? Joe was with me last couple days.
Well, you're lucky then. Carlo's out of town right now, but when he gets back, it ain't gonna be pretty.
No shit.
You better not be shitting me, Vito.
Let's try Giuseppe next. He keeps his ear to the ground. Hey, Giuseppe, I'm looking for Joe Bombo. Is he here today?
Hello, Vito. Yeah, Joe came by today.
Great, I've been looking for him the whole day. Did he say where he was heading?
Well, no, he didn't. I don't think he knew himself.
How come?
Well, he was looking for a job, but before we managed to finish our conversation, a few guys came and took him away.
What? Who?
It was Vinci's people. They said Mr. Vinci wanted a word with him.
You know where they would have went?
No, lo so. Maybe to the bar, the Mona Lisa.
Shit.
Is there something wrong?
Not sure. Let's just say we're not on the best of terms with Mr. Vinci these days.
Yeah, Joe didn't look too happy.
I got a bad feeling about this. I better go find out what's going on.
I hope it's nothing serious. Buona fortuna, Vito.
Oh, nice to see you. Always a pleasure, Vito.
Ciao.
Ciao, ragazzo.
Pursuit of a speeding vehicle.
Copy that.
Freeze, and maybe I won't kill you.
Hiya, fellas.
Look at the balls on this guy.
Nice to see you, too.
Don't move a muscle.
Come on. Listen to the friendly bartender and stop fucking around, Vito. Now, first of all, I gotta ask you to slowly toss your guns on the floor. No funny business, neither. The bartender's got the itchiest trigger finger in town, huh?
I'm not armed.
Okay, so what are you doing here, Vito? We wasn't expecting you.
I'm looking for Joe Barbaro. I heard some of your guys picked him up.
Yeah, maybe.
What are you trying to pull? Me and Joe didn't do nothing to you.
Mr. Vinci doesn't seem to think so. He wanted a few things explained to him, so that's what Joe is doing. And since you've stopped by, why don't we go and join them?
And what if I don't want to?
These guns say you do. But don't worry, it's got a hell of a view.
Hey, what's up, Joe?
The assholes went to take a leak.
Great. But can you explain to me why the fuck we're here?
That old fuck Vinci can't see what's going on right in front of his face. And he thinks I can explain it to him. Idiot.
Oh, the happy couple is here already. Welcome, Vito.
What's going on? You got no reason to treat us like this.
No reason? No reason? First, the business with Leo. And then all hell breaks out in the city. The chinks, they're going nuts. Everybody's fighting like lunatics. And now, those yellow bastards are threatening to kill me. It's out of fucking control. Now, I'm too old for this shit, so you're gonna tell me what the hell's going on here. Come on, I'm all ears.
Mr. Vinci, look, I don't know what the hell's going on here. Believe me. Me and Joe ain't got nothing to do with it.
That ain't what I wanna hear.
Yeah, well, that's your problem. Because we don't know shit about any of this.
That's too bad.
Finally. We don't got much time. We gotta do something.
All right. We'll try to break the pipe. Come on, help me out. I can't do it by myself.
Okay.
One, two, three! One, two, three! Again! One, two, three!
Noise.
Eat that, you asswipe!
This. I'm out of here.
Let me live, please!
That asshole killed him! Asswipe.
You go first. I'll cover you.
Where the fuck you?
What?
You have 2 years. Valid or 6 months.
What?
You're valid.
What is that?
You're voting valid. Uh-huh. We gotta take it in today. I can't take it for you. It has to be the person dropping it off themselves.
Over here, Vito. Vito, they fucked me up pretty good. I think I need a doctor.
Okay, let's get you over to El Greco.
Chest. Every time I breathe, I think they broke my damn ribs.
Take it easy. El Greco's gonna fix you up.
Yeah. Sure. fuck. Every time I cough, it feels like I'm being stabbed in the chest.
Just sit back. The more you whine about it, the worse it's gonna be.
So listen, Vito. Thanks for coming after me and almost getting yourself killed.
Hey, we're in this together, right? Just like always. Now just sit the fuck back before you get blood all over my pants and I really do stab you in the chest.
Oh, you picked a hell of a time to turn into a fucking comedian.
In pursuit of a speeding vehicle. Copy that.
Central Radio, this is Rockin' Ricky Fox. Hey kids, save that dime next time you want to call your main squeeze, because pretty soon you just...
Need a hand?
I can make it.
What do you want me to do with the money?
Take it to Bruno.
All right. At least that'll be out of the way.
Good evening, gentlemen. Oh, what happened to you?
Hey, Doc. I got my ass kicked. I'm coughing up
what
blood.
What is happening today? One of your guys is already here. His name is Antonio Balsamo.
Tony Balls? What happened to him?
Somebody messed him up pretty good. I don't think he's ever going to walk again.
What?
This surprises you? All the blood. All the death. This is the lifestyle you choose. One day your luck is bound to run out. The next time, it could be you.
Enough with the sermon, Doc. You have time to treat Joe?
Yes, but you'll have to wait a minute while I fix Antonio up.
That's okay, Doc.
All right, come in.
Make sure you settle things with Bruno, okay? And Vito, thanks.
Sure thing. Feel better.
and Ricky Fox Show on Empire Central Radio. As we could, what does that mean? Hey, sorry, kids. My producer, Beanie, has just handed me some hot news about a police chase in progress right through Midtown. Our chase is apparently linked to a shootout at a construction site in Midtown, which is owned by Empire Bay property magnate Frank Vinci. With this breaking news update, I'm rockin' Ricky Fox on UCNR Empire Central Radio. Why do you keep doing that?
Hey, I need to see Bruno.
Got the money?
Yeah.
Come on in, then. You're lucky. We were just about to leave.
Good evening. You have the money for me? Or do you wish to extend the deadline?
Here it is.
I have to admit, this is somewhat of a surprise. I heard you boys had some complications.
Yeah, we did.
I heard that Henry is dead. I'm very sorry to hear that. Isaac, count it. So your little business venture was a success?
You got your money, right?
Right, right. It's just that the whole city has been turned upside down. The Chinese think the Italians attacked them, so they're going after Vinci. That's not good. Not good. Would that have anything to do with the reason you borrowed this money?
Sorry, Bruno. That's none of your business.
Thank you, Isaac. It looks like the debt is settled. I don't even know your name.
Vito.
Vito who?
Vito Scaletta.
Scaletta. I knew a Scaletta once. But I must say, you're much better at paying back your debts than he was. His poor wife had to do it for him.
So it was you who lent my father the money.
Your father. Like father, like son. I see you don't approve. But I didn't make him borrow the money, now did I? Just like I didn't make you. If you ever need a loan, you know where to find me.
Sure. I couldn't sleep. Things were bad, and they were only gonna get worse. The truth was gonna come out sooner or later. And then we were gonna have Falcone after us, along with the Chinese and Vinci. This wasn't how I imagined it when we were starting out. I dreamed of money, cars, women, respect, freedom. I guess I ended up getting all that, more or less. But along with it came prison, living in constant fear, and the blood of my friends. I ducked it as long as I could, but it was finally catching up with me. It was all just a matter of time. Yeah, hello.
Vito. Yeah, it's Eddie. Listen, I need you to...
Let me guess. You need me to come by right away, and I should bring a gun.
For once, I don't. Carla wants to see you over at the planetarium.
Can you say what it was about?
Nope. Better head over there now, though. Don't want to keep the man waiting. Yeah, see you, Vito.
Mr. Scaletta, can you get in, please?
Hey, old man. What are you doing back?
Just get in the damn car. Now.
And you are?
This is our friend, Mr. Chu.
All right, so what the hell's going on? What is this?
This is about you. You fucked up good, didn't you? Started a fucking war.
Got no idea what you're talking about.
Don't fuck with me, boy. I've probably forgotten more about this business than you'll ever learn. Half our guys are dead. Half of Mr. Chu's guys are dead. And now the feds are breathing down everybody's necks. Because of you.
Leo, listen.
You listen. If it wasn't for me, you would have already been taken care of. So you're gonna listen to what I have to say, and you're gonna listen good. What you did in Chinatown, that was because of that cocksucker Henry, right? You know who he was working for when he died?
You mean when he was butchered?
He was working for the feds. He was a fucking rat. And that's why Mr. Chu's people did what they did. And that's why the feds are going after Carlo now. But I don't forget my friends, Vito. You did for me, so I did for you. I called in a few favors. Got you one chance to make this right.
Okay, I'm listening.
You're gonna get rid of Carlo. It was all a favor.
And if I refuse?
You die. Frank and the rest of the commission want you dead. So does Mr. Chu. And to top it all off, you vouched for a rat. You think Carlo's gonna let that slide? You're a dead man walking.
When?
Now. Every minute we wait is another minute we give to the feds. He's holed up at that observatory of his. You know something's up. Carlo Falcone is a lot of things, but stupid ain't one of them.
All right. Stop the car.
Remember, kid, this is your last chance.
Hey, fellas.
Hey, Vito. The boss wants to see you.
Good. I want to see him, too.
One thing, though, Vito. I gotta take your gun.
Yeah, all right. Here you go.
But...
God damn.
Well, look who it is. This is who they said? This is an insult. What'd they tell you, Vito? Take care of me and all's forgiven? You really think they're just gonna let you walk after everything you did? Then again, chumps like you never do think about the big picture. But your buddy Joe understands, don't you, Joe?
What the fuck is this?
I could ask you the same question.
Loyalty's a funny thing, huh, Vito? No such thing as friendship in this business. Didn't your old pal Leo teach you that while you're sucking his cock back in the can? You're just a fucking pawn, Vito. It's all you ever were. When are you gonna realize
that? Joe, you just gotta trust me.
You think I give a shit about the feds? Or those tired old fucks on the commission? They're using you, Vito. Just like Clemente used you. Just like I used you. Just like that rat fuck Henry used you. You vouched for that piece of shit. Brought him into my house.
And now, you dumb fuck, you're gonna pay for it. Now, Joe.
Hey, if you're gonna pull that trigger, do it already.
What are you waiting for?
Vito, let's shoot this cocksucker.
Remember what we talked about,
tree.
Joe? You're gonna throw all that away? Do it!
Two.
Now!
Back me up, Vito! You're fucking brilliant! You shoot like my sister. Come on, think of something. Hurry up. I'm the best.
What? Oh my god.
Somebody kill these two psychos! You dumb bastard, you don't stand a chance. You can't kill them all.
Vito. Way to go, Vito.
Know something, Carlo? For the last 10 years, all I done was kill. I killed for my country. I killed for my family. I killed anybody that got in my way. But this one... this one's for me.
Fuck you!
Fucking prick.
I sure as hell hope you know what you're doing here.
Don't worry, I took care of it.
You'll see. So, what was he talking about back there?
Nothing. He made me an offer, that's all.
Yeah, I figured out that much. What kind of offer?
He wanted me to whack you. Said he'd make me a capo. Give me my own crew. You know, pretty much everything I ever wanted.
Yeah? So why the hell didn't you do it?
Remember that $5 you owe me?
What the hell is this?
It's all right, Joe.
Is it done?
It's done.
All right, then. Looks like a celebration is in order. Come on. Let's head to the cat house.
Sounds good to me.
Come with me, Vito. There's more we need to talk about.
All right, we'll see you over there.
So what's the big secret? Hey, what the hell's going on? Where they taking Joe?
Sorry, kid. Joe wasn't part of our deal.
Stars and shine above. We light our way.
you love.
Jumping as a jailbird.
And you'll rule this crazy land with me.
Jumping as a jailbird.
I'm the cheeky man. That's who I mean. That's who I mean.
Mafia in America was
was in New Orleans in the 1860s. I believe a couple of Sicilians, they murdered the police chief there, and it was a big case. I don't remember what the outcome was, whether they got convicted or not, but that was the first time I believe that the mafia was known to be in the United States. And of course, New York was a huge stronghold. They had the Black Hand back then. It started out when people were kind of, you know, preying, Italians were preying on other Italians in neighborhoods, and I think you saw the movie Gangs of New York, fairly accurate, but that's something that I think, you know, people are not aware of, that really the first presence of the mafia in the United States was in the city of New Orleans. That's number one. Another thing I want to bring up, and this is really important, I think some of you out there think that when you become a made man, or you become associated with the Cosa Nostra in this country in some way, that all of a sudden you're making a ton of money. You know, everybody says, oh, they were millionaires and they were wealthy, and you know, you come into that life and you make a ton of money. It is not true. That is a myth, that is a fallacy. In the Colombo family, we had, at the time that I was in the life, we had about 115 made guys, guys that actually took the oath. Out of that 115, I can tell you this, there were about 20 of us, maybe 25, that were real earners, really earning money and bringing money into not only our own coffers, but into the families. The rest of the guys, the other 90-95, you know, who had a no-show job, who was a terrible gambler, who did we get a union job, who was trying to push a few numbers, who was sneaking on the side doing a little drug business, who was extorting somebody, not wealthy. You know, you hear all these stories about people making millions. It's not true. The night that I got made, Halloween night, 1975, there were six of us that night. After we took the oath, we did this in Anthony Colombo, Joe Lewis, and after we all took the oath, we did what all Italians do all the time. When we were being one out of bank. And so six of us were there.
Just how it goes, so that's the thing.
in prisons all the time. Anytime I go to a church and speak anywhere, I always ask if they have a juvenile prison ministry that I can go in and give some encouragement. I do have an impact. Look, I've been there, I've done that. They understand that, you know, if I was able to come out of a tough situation and transform my life, of course, if I am in a situation that doesn't get me. Try it as an adult, and they're not going to have, most of the time, they're not going to have a charge.
Tell them also, when I speak to these kids, they say to me, Michael, how can you get out of the light? I tell you what I did. Whenever I go into an institution to speak to these young people, I will not go in unless there's a program I can send them to that I know they can get help. Because you can't tell a gangbanger to leave the gang and keep him in his own neighborhood. It's dangerous for him. You got to give him a way out. You got to provide him with something. And that's what I do. Every church just about has a ministry that can handle this type of issue problem in our life. I suggest a local church, a local program, go out there, and you've got to get these kids with the right accountability, the right information coming to them. That's all you can